"I'm going to try to save you, Unc," he said, just as if the marble image could hear him. And then he shook the crooked hand of the Crooked Magician, who was already busy hanging the four kettles in the fireplace, and, picking up his basket, left the house. The Patchwork Girl followed him, and after them came the Glass Cat. End of chapter 5. Chapter 6. The Journey. Ojo had never traveled before, and so he only knew that the path down the mountainside led into the open Munchkin country, where large numbers of people dwelt. Scraps was quite new and not supposed to know anything of the Land of Oz, while the Glass Cat admitted she had never wandered very far away from the magician's house. There was only one path before them at the beginning, so they could not miss their way, and for a time they walked through the thick forest in silent thought, each one impressed with the importance of the adventure they had undertaken. Suddenly, the Patchwork Girl laughed. It was funny to see her laugh, because her cheeks wrinkled up, her nose tipped, her silver button eyes twinkled, and her mouth curled at the corners in a comical way. "Has something pleased you?" asked Ojo, who was feeling solemn and joyless through thinking upon his uncle's sad fate. "Yes," she answered. "Your world pleases me, for it is a queer world, and life in it is queerer still. Here am I, made from an old bedquilt and intended to be a slave to Margolotte, rendered free as air by an accident that none of you could foresee. I am enjoying life and seeing the world, while the woman who made me is standing helpless as a block of wood. If that isn't funny enough to laugh at, I don't know what is."
"You're not seeing much of the world yet, my poor innocent Scraps," remarked the cat. "The world doesn't consist wholly of the trees that are on all sides of us.